Welcome to this brief video tutorial demonstrating the deployment process of Rancher Prime on Google Cloud. This is Abdelrahman Mohamed, Global Solutions Architect for Google Alliance at SUSE, and I'm excited to guide you through this demonstration. Rancher Prime offers an enterprise Kubernetes management platform built on the open source project Rancher. Rancher Prime, a unified cloud native platform, empowers customers to effortlessly manage their Kubernetes clusters anywhere and with any provider. It can provision Kubernetes from a hosted provider, provision compute nodes and install Kubernetes on them, or import existing Kubernetes clusters running anywhere. Rancher Prime adds significant value on top of Kubernetes by centralizing authentication and role-based access control RPAC for all the Kubernetes clusters, giving global admins the ability to control cluster access from one location. It reduces the complexity of managing Kubernetes deployment. It improves security posture through hardened images. It streamlines application delivery with the Rancher Prime application collection. In addition to that, Rancher Prime provides enterprise-grade support. When it comes to deploying Rancher Prime in a production environment, the flexibility is impressive. You have the option to deploy Rancher Prime on any certified Kubernetes distribution such as Google Kubernetes Engine GKE Standard, Rancher Kubernetes Engine 2 RKE2, Amazon Elastic Kubernetes EKS, Azure Kubernetes Engine AKS, and more. Today I will deploy Rancher on Google Kubernetes Engine GKE Standard. Before proceeding, I must ensure that the Helm, kubectl, and gcloud tools are installed on my workstation. Also, I may have a DNS record for the Rancher Prime hostname. To explore Rancher Prime subscription options via Google Cloud Marketplace, please reach out to your dedicated SUSE sales representative. They will provide valuable guidance on the process and ensure a seamless experience. Additionally, stay tuned for the pay-as-you-go model, set to be officially available in the second half of 2024. Let's start by creating the GKE standard cluster hosting Rancher Prime. Here I have a ready to deploy GKE standard cluster. Let's review the cluster configurations before I hit the create button. The cluster name will be Rancher Prime Cluster 1. I will create a regional cluster within the US West 1 region. I will install the latest and the greatest Rancher Prime version 2.8.3. According to the Rancher support matrix, which I will put in the video description, the highest supported Kubernetes version for Rancher Manager on GKE is version 1.28. So I will use the regular release channel and Kubernetes version 1.28.8. I will use the default pool for this demo, but modify the pool configurations. For optimal performance, I will set the default pool to have at least one node per zone and enable the cluster autoscaler to scale the pool node count up to 5 nodes distributed across the 3 zones. I will keep the default OS image used by the GKE cluster. Also, I will keep the default machine configurations to use the E2 series. But I need to use a more powerful machine type. I will change the machine type to E2 standard 4, which has 4 virtual CPUs and 16 gigabytes of memory. You will find a link for the Rancher installation hardware specs in the video description. I will keep the default boot disk type and boot disk size. For networking, I will keep using the default network and default subnet for this demo. Now all the basic necessary configurations for the GKE cluster are set. I will hit the create button and pause the video until the cluster creation is completed successfully. Now the GKE cluster is up and running, as we can see it here. Let's connect to the cluster and check its status. First, I need to list the currently created clusters. Then let's connect to the created cluster. And finally, list the cluster nodes. The rancher cluster needs an ingress so that the rancher manager can be accessed from outside the GKE cluster. Let's create an Nginx ingress controller. First, I need to clear the screen here. Then I need to add the Nginx ingress helm chart repository and update the current repositories list. The next step is to list the available helm chart versions via the ingress Nginx helm chart repository. According to the Nginx technical specs that you will find in the video description, I can use the Nginx Ingress Controller Helm Chart version 4.1.2 with Kubernetes version 1.28. So I'm going to deploy a new Nginx Ingress Controller Helm release. Here I instructed Helm to create a new Helm release called Ingress Nginx. The release will be deployed within the Ingress Nginx namespace. The Ingress Controller service will be exposed using the Google Cloud Load Balancer. The Ingress Controller uses Helm Chart version 4.1.2. And finally, I instructed Helm to create the namespace if it doesn't exist. Let's check the Nginx Ingress Controller release status. First, I need to clear the screen here. It has been deployed successfully, as we can see here. Now I need to extract the Ingress Controller service external IP address. The external IP address for this demo will be 34.82.35.200. Finally, let's create a DNS record for the rancher manager that uses the Ingress Controller external IP address that we can see it here. As we can see here, I'm going to use the external IP address of the Nginx Ingress Controller for a DNS record called rancher.suse-gcp-demos.net. The next step is to deploy Cert Manager, which will manage Kubernetes certificates. Rancher uses Cert Manager to generate and renew TLS certificates for Rancher HA deployments automatically. For this demo, I will use the self-signed certificates for Rancher. Let's clear the screen again here. The first step is to install Cert Manager custom resource definitions. Then I need to add the Cert Manager Helm chart repository and update the current repositories list. Then I need to install the Cert Manager Helm release. Here I instructed Helm to create a new Helm release called Cert Manager. The release will be deployed within the Cert Manager namespace. Helm will install Cert Manager Helm chart version 1.13.1. And finally, I instructed Helm to create the namespace if it doesn't exist. Let's check the created Cert Manager Helm chart release status. It has been deployed successfully, as we can see it here. Once we have installed Cert Manager, we can verify it's deployed correctly by checking the Cert Manager namespace for running deployments and pods. Now it's time to deploy Rancher. Let's first clear the screen. I will install Rancher Manager for Rancher Prime 2.8.3. So first I need to add the Helm chart repo for Rancher Prime and update the Helm chart repositories. Then I need to create a new namespace hosting Rancher. The next step is to create the Rancher Manager Helm release. First, let's quickly check the Rancher Prime Helm chart versions. I'm going to use the chart version 2.8.3, full rancher version 2.8.3. Now I need to deploy rancher prime release. Here I instructed Helm to create a new Helm release called rancher. The release will be deployed within the kettle system namespace. Helm will install rancher prime Helm chart version 2.8.3. The initial rancher admin password is rancher. I will change it right after the first login. Rancher manager can be accessed from outside the GKE cluster using the Nginx ingress. And finally, I instructed Helm to create the namespace if it doesn't exist. Now we need to check the rancher manager deployment status. I will pause the video until the rancher deployment is completed successfully. Now rancher deployment has been completed successfully. We can verify this by listing the deployed Helm charts in the kettle system namespace. Let's log into Rancher Manager for Rancher Prime using the already created DNS record, as we can see it here. I need to accept the self-signed certificate. Let's see the initial password set during the Helm release deployment. I accepted the end user license agreement and terms and conditions. Here I can see that I'm using Rancher Prime. Let's check that we use Rancher Prime 2.8.3. We can see this here. Finally, I need to change the initial admin password. Congratulations, you have deployed Rancher Prime on Google Cloud. If you have any further questions or need additional assistance, please feel free to reach out via email at google@suse.com. Thank you for your time and the best of luck with your Rancher Prime deployment on Google Cloud.